WinCC V8 Tips and Tricks Number 4, Animating SVG Graphics Objects. In this video, I'm going to show you how to animate the SVG version 2 library objects that are in WinCC 8. So if this is something you need to know how to do, let's get started. So I've been getting a lot of questions about the SVG library. I actually got a question from subscriber Nestora Para. So Nestora, thank you for the question. And he is asking how to animate or change the color of these objects. And so I wanted to kind of point out the difference. The version 1 SVG library, I think, came out in WinCC 7.4, I believe. And these are SVG images, which they're great for web. They're very efficient, very kind of small file size. But if we look at the properties, under symbol properties, there's nothing. If we go to colors, I can pull up the color palette, but it doesn't really have an effect. So even if I use these guys, it doesn't do anything. And if you turn on flashing, nothing happens in runtime if you try to add animations to these. I've looked through a lot of these, and they're pretty much all the same. These are just images, and they don't have anything that you can really use to animate. That's kind of a problem if you are using that. That's kind of one of the fundamental things of building SCADA pages. In version 2, we have basically the same objects. And I'll just kind of pull out a couple of these here. But the difference here is anything that is in this symbol properties section, you can animate. And so most of these will have at least a basic color and a contrast color. So these will actually pull up your color palette, and I can change the color of these. So all we really have to do is put a standard animation on here. So we use a dynamic dialogue, you can put a script or an animation. I'll do dynamic dialogue, but I can just use this. And I'll use my red pump on. Yeah, I know it's a motor. So I'll do Boolean, and based on this tag, if it's on, will be red. If it's off, will be green. Click OK, and then I go over to my tag section. Here's my red pump on. I'll just pop that up there, save this, go to runtime. And there's my animation. So the thing to remember with these SVG objects, if you need to animate these, make sure you're using the version 2. And anything that is in your symbol properties, you can animate. Anything else, everything's just grayed out and you can't really do anything with. So I'll do one more quick example just to make sure you get your money's worth out of this. If we go back to the SVG library and look in tanks, and I found this the other day when I was teaching a class, but I'm just going to pull a tank out. And some of these actually have some pretty nice properties. Here you can see that they have a fill window, and you can do a reflective filling, or you can do like a filling bar, and then you can, of course, animate the color as well. And on my fill level, I'm just going to attach my tank level tag, and then I'm going to animate the color. So I'll use a dynamic dialogue, and in this case, we're going to go look at the tank level, and I'm on analog, so I'll just hit add a couple of times, and I'll just say up to 20. Let's say that's too low, so I want the fill color to be yellow, and then mid-range, it'll be blue all the way up to, let's just say 90, and then anything over 90 will make red. This will give something nice to the operator. So we'll just save this. I'll go to my tags. I'll pull my mix tank level right out here. We'll save, go to runtime, and I'll do something below. So that's 18 and it's yellow. We go just above that, it's blue. And if we go above 90, it's going to be red. So you can use all the standard animations and dynamics on these objects. So I hope this was helpful. And of course, if you have a question, I may do a video on it and give you a shout out. So see you next time.